after Mary Immaculate, my first point of reflection would be honor given to our Blessed Mother Mary, our separated brethren, separated. Now, there was one church and a group of Christians protested and went away from the main line Catholic Church. So therefore Protestants are separated brethren. They accuse us of worshipping Mary. Ever since the Catholic Church landed in Manipur, the missionaries went about preaching. That was the propaganda spread against the Catholic mission. Catholics are pagans, they use water, they worship, they do the puja, and they worship Mary. We don't worship Mary. So clear to us. Human beings, we honor one another, especially great personalities among us. We honor them. If Chief Minister were to come to our place, we make our place worthy of receiving him. Greater than Chief Minister, head of the state, the governor is coming. Governor, that place will be made more worthy. Security personnel will come, check everything, that no danger is perpetrated against governor's company. So we honor one another, especially the greater among us, with great respect. Now, the Bible says, the angel of the Lord came to Mary, said, "Hey, highly favored one, the Lord is with you." Who is the angel? Angels are God's messengers. They bring God's word, God's sentiments, God's love to persons. "Hey, highly favored, the Lord is with you." "Hey, Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you." Meaning the same, different translations. If God is honoring our Blessed Mother with these words, why can't we honor our Blessed Mother? The words that we use to honor her is from the Bible. Hey, Mary, full of grace. So here I would like to say, we say rosary, we say prayers to our Blessed Mother Mary, morning prayer, evening prayer. When we say the prayer, we must look at our Blessed Mother Mary. Hey, Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Elizabeth, full of the Holy Spirit, blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. Elizabeth, full of the Holy Spirit, means me. So we are repeating the words of the Bible. Hey, Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Hey, Mary, full of grace, like mantra, without thinking, if we say, we are honoring our Blessed Mother, much less. But when look at our Blessed Mother Mary, hey, Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Then the church puts it, Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners. Mary is powerful. She can pray to God and obtain grace for us. So, this particular, there was a story, a beautiful story. A priest who was not living a good life, died. said, I send you to hell. And Mary appeared, son, give him a second chance. The priest recovered. He was in coma, about to die. Then, brain, we can say, was declared dead. That's why he could meet the judge, the supreme judge of the universe, who condemned him to hell. Mother Mary, son, give him a second chance. The person recovered. He became consciousness and became a very, very good priest. Mary is powerful. She can turn the judgment. She can give second chance to us. That's why. Therefore, Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for our sins. Today, as we celebrate the feast of our Blessed Mother Mary, feast of the Church, Mary Immaculate, we honor her. We resolve to say Hail Mary. When we say Hail Mary, we look at her and with the full love and conviction and love conviction, we address her. Thus, our prayer will become meaningful, personal, efficacious. Blessed Mother Mary is honored far above the women of Israel, Judith, for example, cut off the head of the enemy of Israel. She was honored. You are the highest honor of Israel. Our Lady is far, far greater than Judith. The Ark of the Covenant, which contained the Word of God, the stick of Moses, which parted the sea, and the food, heavenly food, again, the Ark of the Covenant, covered with gold. Mary is far greater than the Ark of the Covenant because she carried in her womb the Almighty God, the Son of God. That's why we honor Mary. Every celebration of Mary's feast make us love her more and more and more. Today's gospel, today's Sunday, rejoice. Gaudate, rejoice. Lent, Advent, and Lent are seasons of preparation for the feast of Christmas and for the feast of Easter. In the midst of preparation, with the sentiments of sorrow for our sins, sentiments of searching for God, looking forward to God, abandoning our way of life, we focus our attention to God, to be better ourselves. So these are sentiments of repentance, sadness, less of joy. But today the Church says, rejoice. We rejoice because our salvation is near. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. The Spirit has anointed me to preach the good news to the poor, captives, freedom to